Tobia is from Milan, Italy. He's educated first in Milan and then in Copenhagen later. He started as an architect in the year 1998, working in different fields, doing wood designs applied in retail, hospitality, exhibitions, museums, product designs, and corporate identity. Besides being a designer, he's also contributing substantially in design education, such as Milan Polytechnic. His works have earned much recognition and many important awards. And he's recently operating a design consultancy firm in China, serving big companies such as Tension, ZTE, Huawei, and TCL. May I please?
Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. I'm the local guy here. I live here. I work with a Chinese designer with a Chinese company. So you're gonna forgive me. Maybe some parts of my speech are gonna be maybe a little bit unpleasant. But remember that when I talk about Chinese design, I always say we, because I feel part of this vibe of Chinese design. So as you understand, I have two studios. One is in Milan, and one is in Shenzhen. I wanted to spend like just 1 minute to tell you who I am. I started working with this guy. His name is Dino Gallina. He was considered one of the father of industrial design in Italy. He brought people like Marcel Breuer or Carlo Scarpa. And I was very lucky to work with him at the beginning of my career. And recently I got in touch with the Sino-European Design Union, which is a platform that connects Chinese companies and European designers that actually powers my office in Shenzhen. In the meantime, I worked for almost 20 years in shops design, showrooms, offices, designing the offices for Tencent recently in lower China. Five-star hotels, the market of hotels was pretty satisfying in China recently. And hospitals, exhibitions and museums, and products that were sold all over the world for and used for by landscape designers. And naturally product design for furniture and in China for electronics. This is one of our last works, always for China, for the bullet train stations, is the new entrance for them. And of course, a lot of university lecturing for EID and Polytechnic School of Milan. And I'm sorry, this is the boring, the extremely boring part. I was very scared of giving a speech after a giant like Michael Young. And so I said, maybe I should bring to these people the picture of my holidays, which are better looking, and tell them why they actually choose China, why they actually came to China and to Guangdong. Guangdong is an amazing place. I don't know if you know, but 33%, one third of the electronics product in the planet are produced here. This is the factory of the world for many compartments. And so it's incredible how much this area actually exports, trades with the rest of the planet, and how many ideas are coming here from the rest of the planet. It's kind of strange if you take a look at the opposite. So of the market of ideas, there are not many ideas nowadays coming from China and going to the rest of the world. And that's pretty strange, because if you have an idea that actually changes the market like this one, you know, ideas are worth money. Take a look at that. You pay in the price of this guy, you pay 10% of production, 30% for design, marketing, whatever, the soft stuff, and then a 40% margin. So this is something the Chinese people are really sensible to. Ideas are worth money. And this is probably the biggest revolution, the biggest leap, the biggest change that China can do during this year, which is changing from a production manufacturing place to a place where ideas are built and services for design are built. And China is probably the best country in the planet that can be able to do that, because we still have a manufacturing network and nowadays a huge network of startups. I don't know if you know, there are 600 accelerators and incubators in Shenzhen at the moment. It's actually more than the Silicon Valley. So, and here we go with the pictures of my colleagues. I started to travel a little bit around China, actually followed sometimes by my clients, sometimes by my team, to understand which were the roots of Chinese design and which was the way to take Chinese design to be the best design in the world. A lot of pictures I took of me and my team. A lot of pictures of me were taken. This is a mystery. I don't know why it happened. And then I found this treasure map, and I made this archaeological discovery. And I actually found the 8 commandments of Chinese design for the future. Naturally, this is me with the commandments, with the stones. So the first commandment is don't replicate. It won't take you anywhere. The ability of the Chinese culture to make the same sign over and over again to achieve perfection sometimes takes to the ability of copying things from the other. This means that today China is the factory of the world, but there's a small development for ideas and research and design. There's a famous sentence about an Italian designer called Bruno Munari that says, if you see a picture and you say, I can design it too, it means that you can reproduce it. Otherwise, you would have done it before. And, you know, the labor costs will be soon higher. And if some of the ideas that are here will go back to their countries, China will be left 3 to 6 years behind. And that's what we don't want. The second is design for the real world. The icon is just a meaning. I mean with this that the icon represents an object in the real world, but it's not the real object. So a rendering, an image, is a representation of the project, it's not the project. An image is meant, and the rendering by the computer is meant to sell an idea. It's not meant to sell a picture. Not even artists nowadays sell pictures. The third is don't waste money in bad decisions. Again, as somebody said before, get surrounded by the best people. The right amount of money today and the good decisions today are less money tomorrow. So even if there's a huge cash flow and if you have a lot of money, this doesn't mean that we have to waste it in bad projects or in bad designs. This one is bad design is polluting, is pollution. Architecture, interior design, product design, they cost energy, they cost materials, they cost money. The best we do them, the best we design, the less garbage we will leave to our children. So, probably thinking about the afterlife of the product, which is something not very fashionable here, it's a new way to intend the future of design in China. The fifth is language is important. Chinese language is fantastic, but sometimes it lacks in technicality. I think Chinese designers, Chinese design in general, must find its own language, which can be a spoken language, can be English, French, Swahili, whatever, or sketches, but also its own way to communicate properly in the chain of the in the production chain. So, the client, designer, supplier, so on. Research is important, and technology is not everything. Understanding a market before producing for that market is the only way to design. There's no way to make a good product if you don't understand the history, if you don't understand the products that has been done before. And this takes you to innovation and not to replicas. In other words, knowing the history is managing the future. The seventh is focus on quality and not on quantity. This is all about this history. If you take a look at what happened in the 70s in Western countries, our company wanted to grow bigger and bigger and bigger, and then they understood that they had a lot of costs. So in what they did in the 80s is that they wanted to make more money. Margin was the word. And then they discovered that they lost the trust of their customers. In the 90s, they wanted to build quality products, and quality was the word. Everybody was doing total quality, and then nowadays we're all on branding. I think China can learn about our mistakes and be ready to take this inheritance and make designs that really focus on quality. The last one is, don't be different, be better. This is something that I hear a lot from my Chinese clients. Everybody wants to be different, right? You can be different being the stupidest guy in town. We have to shift the attention from being different to be better. So making better design is probably a must for the future. Thank you very much.